One of the most common questions into the technical assistance center is to why the length did not fail on their tester when it exceeded the test limit. Let's take a look at the example here. The length reported was 95.2 meters, around about 312 feet. If we tap here, we'll see our lengths. And you get four different length readings because there are four different twists in the cable, and the standard requires us to do a pass-fail on the shortest length. So you'll find that three of them are actually grayed out, and the shortest one is the one that we're evaluating. But you'll notice the limit says 90 meters. Why didn't it fail? In the ANSI TIA 1152 standard, in section, I think it is 4.2.3.1, go look that up yourself. The limit is the limit plus the nominal uncertainty of MVP, which is stated as 10%. What does that mean in English? In English, that means that the length has to be exceeded by 10%. In other words, this would have to get to 99 meters or 324 and a half feet before it would actually turn into a fail. Now, people normally get really wound up about this, but here's the reality. The active equipment doesn't care so much about the length. What it cares about is the length-dependent parameters, insertion loss and propagation delay. So if the insertion loss passes and the propagation delay passes, who really cares whether it's 95 meters or not? And funny enough, when you go and do an ISO test, in ISO, there is no pass-fail on the length measurement. Now, that's not an excuse to go to 99 meters or 324 and a half feet. But in ISO, that's exactly the same philosophy is, if the length-dependent parameters like insertion loss and propagation delay are met, then it's okay. There's nothing wrong with the length being 95 meters or 312 feet odd. So that's the 10% rule for length.